I have a legit question. Can anyone explain to me how in 2024 we lose cell phone service and, you know, you go up into the mountains or in a rural area and you lose 5G or you don't have any service at all, but we were able to call the moon from a landline? Just a question. Here's a question for you. Can anyone explain to me how Antarctica is 5.5 million miles in size, which is 1.5 times the size of the continental United States, and we're only able to be a tourist in a certain amount of the continent, but it looks like this? These are the comments that kill me on that video. So, when NASA can show me an image of the sun, the moon, the earth, and stars all in one photo, I'll be on board. And on top of that, when NASA can provide me a perfectly clear image of a cruise ship on the other side of the earth that is upside down, I will fully 100% wholeheartedly believe that we live on a globe. But until that day comes, when that information can be provided by NASA, who has all of these wonderful technology things of, you know, in space, you're never gonna get me to flip what it is that I believe. So have a great day. So this is actually a really good topic that I guess I need to elaborate on. And I apologize, I have been kind of emotional. So thank you for your question. And yes, I did think about what I said. So let's take a look at this together, shall we? When it says upside down on the other side of the planet. So we do live on a globe based off of the science that everybody talks about, correct? I mean, there's a difference between science and pseudoscience, but yes, based off of what we have been indoctrinated and educated to know is we live on a globe, okay? So a globe is round, it is a sphere, it is three-dimensional, okay? Let me show you. There is a globe. Do you see right here what is on the bottom of the globe that we are indoctrinated to know? There is ocean. Ocean, okay? Cruise ships sail in the ocean, do they not? So technically on a globe, it is spherical, meaning that in the ocean over here, it would be upside down and gravity would keep them. But technically on a globe in space, they would be upside down. Am I wrong? I mean, please tell me if I'm incorrect based off of how that is. With a North Pole and a South Pole, would that not be the case? In the Southern Hemisphere of the globe, would we not be upside down? If I'm incorrect, I would love to hear your educational responses in a kind, nice manner with a mature conversation on how, based off of that view of what a globe looks like, on a sphere, that I am incorrect in what I said. Because I'm pretty sure if there was a cruise ship in the ocean in the southern hemisphere, they would be upside down. I mean, logically, I'd love to hear if you have a different response though. In a kind way though, please, because I don't need to have negativity.
Okay, so I honestly don't even really know how I got here, but it's fine. Let's get into this, shall we? So I can't even stop laughing, honestly, but there's been so many comments about how there is no up and down or north and south in space. Okay, that's fine. But when I Google the Earth's axis in space, okay, the North Pole is at the top. the top axis, and then it goes down to the South Pole or the bottom axis. Okay, so regardless of which way you look at the Earth from space, okay, the North will always be at the top and the South is always at the bottom. I do not remember any time in my whole entire life of existence knowing that we flip around. Earth flips axes and the South becomes the top and the North becomes the bottom. I never have I ever heard of that happening. So regardless of if up and down doesn't exist in space, I completely understand what you're saying of where you're at because of gravity on Earth. I understand the concept of gravity. Let's get that out in the open. I'm pretty sure you're all just misconstruing what it is that I'm saying at this point, which is comical in itself. So the Earth has always been on one axis. North Pole is at the top. South Pole is at the bottom. Google it. I have a picture I'm going to put at the end. I just can't. I'm struggling here. So I think that until the next conspiracy video, I think I'm done with this part of it because I have done a pretty good job at demonstrating what it is that I'm asking for or what it is that I've been talking about. And I mean, there's always going to be some sort of logical, scientifical reply that somebody's going to come up with. But the Earth has always had the North Pole at the top and the South Pole at the bottom. Even when I went to school and learned about it, it's always been that way. I've never had Antarctica be at the top of the globe, ever. So Northern, Southern, it's always been depicted that way, even in images from space. So please make it make sense. Of course, on Earth, we're not going to feel like, if you believe we live on a globe, you're not going to feel like you're upside down and the blood's rushing to your head because of gravity. Kindness. But this just takes the cake, guys. Like, I... I think you've completely missed my point. So, have a great day.
The Antarctic Treaty, if you want to take screenshots. Could clear all this up and just let us freely travel. I got too much to hide. More land, resources, maybe a people's group down there around us. All right, guys, good luck.
Moon rock to was it the Prime Minister of Holland, Neil Armstrong, and Buzz Aldrin and Michael Collins signed on this plaque, and they gave this moon rock to this guy in Holland, and it turned out to be petrified wood. It was fake. They did fake some photos. There's a photo of Michael Collins who's on a moonwalk from like Gemini 15. And it's not a real photo. It's a photo of him from the test runs that they did that's in a warehouse, and they blacked out all the background. It's been proven. They reversed the image and blacked out the background. You can see the two of them. If you overlay them, they right. line up perfectly. It's the exact same image.
Right.
So someone, whether it is a an overzealous PR agent for NASA or a journalist at the time, who knows sure. who actually made that photograph, but somebody did and tried to pass that photo off as space. So there's some right. deception. We right. know that one is 100%.
Sure.
So then you look at the other ones. You look at the videos of guys falling down, getting yanked back up, and bouncing around like they're on trampolines, and some videos where they're right. hiding behind the lunar rover. Like, what the fuck are you doing? If you guys tear your suits, you're dead.
Sure.
You guys are jumping around on the moon like you're having a party up there?
Right.
Is that real?
Right.
How come I can't get a fucking regular camera through the radar machine, the x-ray machine at the airport, but you guys can fly through the radiation of space, and that shit comes out, but well, those cameras were insulated. They were-
the government faked the Apollo moon landings to assert dominance in the space race?
No, to make money, actually. Mostly to make money. But yes, it actually absolutely was false. The amount of money that NASA has been able to bleed out of the government, actually out of your pockets, because of taxation and things like that, has been extraordinary. And of course, it's just funded the cabal. So NASA is a cabal entity, and pretty much almost everything that they have represented to people has been false to encourage, of course, to justify, of course, their extraordinary hoarding of money. People would say spending of money, but it's actually been a hoarding of money. And so they have to keep up the facade, and they have to artificiate all kinds of things that look like they're doing spectacular things. So people will just be like, oh, yes, we are so happy that you are taking more money from us because we are really doing some best absolute fantastic things.
Money can! What's that, yeah, Choshan? Archie, yo, Yang Chi!
I hold him up.
This is raw, unedited video, just sent via satellite.
And right when he says, going to throttle up, that's seconds after that, that's when the explosion happens. Now understand, this is very important and key to this follow-up video, is you're going to understand that all the supposed VIPs, they know what just supposedly happened. They heard what happened. They saw the explosion. And way after the fact, you're going to see them still smiling, cracking, you know, smiles with each other, laughing, giggling. And just take a look at how clear it is that these are nothing more than hand-picked crisis actors, and how the supposed family members and VIPs, certain ones are spotlighted, and you can see them clearly smiling and laughing, like I said. It just happened. You hear some people screaming. Okay, you hear them screaming. They know, they seen the explosion. They know what's going on. So make that crystal clear. When you see them laughing and smiling later on, it's not because you're confused. It's because they're crisis actors and they think the scene's over. They don't know the cameras are still on them. You hear the people screaming in the back. You know, these actors. And again, no confusion of what supposedly is taking place. Nothing more than a large firework that went off with this supposed shuttle explosion. And they know it.
Picture you were just seeing is Christy McCullough's parents watching in horror. These are the students.
See, little kid pointing up. smiling
from her school.
Right here, another person smiling. Again, they know they're going to be on camera, but they can't help cracking that smile. You see this smile? You see this look? This is not someone that's in horror of what they just saw. Same with this lady up here. Look at that big smile. This is not from squinting at the sky, like someone claimed in my previous video. This is a smile. Now she goes in acting gear. And this guy here.
Many of them probably had their view blocked just again, as we did with the television camera.
You should get an award.
Huge fireball and a huge cloud of smoke. They may not realize yet what has happened.
Covering up. He's covering up for the people that he's seen on his monitor smiling. You heard the screaming from some of the actors. Some of the actors knew their key, knew what to do. And others, they didn't have a clue of how to act and knowing the camera was spotlighted on them.
You see concern etched on their faces. The breath that they've been holding released. And then the realization.
Now she's acting.
That something is.
Clearly. A firework.
At that point, all that remained was.
My dynamic officer that the vehicle has exploded. Our director confirms that. We are looking at checking whether we come.
They're telling everybody, all the crisis actors, you need to get on the buses. Your job is done for the day. Hear that again. Get on the buses.
Our director confirms that. We are looking at checking whether we come.
On the buses. Now, everybody is supposedly aware of what took place. The shuttle supposedly exploded with people on board, and now this is where it all starts. Acting. Knowing the camera will be on them. But here's the problem. Here's where the smiling starts again. Clear. No screen-o-matic in the way this time. It's going to be lower, hopefully, with this recording. And I want to stop at this particular moment, at this still, when these two crisis actors take a look at each other. They know, of course, it's all a hoax. They can't help kind of like give that smile to each other, like a nod, like, you know, we're in on this type of thing. Right there. There you go again. Right there. What is this? Robbie Parker's dad? Ha! What a joke.
Edward and Grace Corrigan. They're about 3.5 miles away.
The reason they took the camera off them, because they saw them smiling when they shouldn't have. Right there, looking at each other, smiling, giggling, because they know it was nothing more than a fireworks show. They did not lose their daughter. Bogus. Right there. People can't see this? You're in denial. Period. Now, as far as these astronauts and this pyramid worship, this capsule is nothing more than a pyramid that they're praying to. All these Masons involved in the game. And the supposed astronaut that was killed during that supposed disaster. Look at this monument they made for her. And of course the pyramid structure in the back. Freemasons that control, that run this world, control NASA, control our entire society.
It came in the mail, and y'all are opening it with me. Ooh. Smell. Here we go.
The flat Earth map dates back over 1,000 years. This map is credited to being created by a Persian astronomer. His name was Al-Biruni, and he lived between 973 AD to 1048 AD. It's the official map of the United Nations and also the United States Geological Survey. It used to be present in many places before the creation of NASA and the Antarctic Treaty in 1959. Here you see it with Admiral Byrd. This map has been restored by Dmitry from Russia with suggestions of mine, Eddie Alenkar. Known by my YouTube channel Flat Earth Banjo, I asked Dmitry to include the Bermuda Triangle and Point Nemo, a place deep in the Pacific where NASA buries rockets. Then Robert Tuzzi, a professional mapmaker, came along and enhanced the map even more. There are many people now selling this map online, but if you could order it from my online store, I would greatly appreciate it. Visit my online store now and order one of the items. I humbly thank you.